Hi, I'm Doc Martin for Reading What? Who? Well, it's books and review, authors, artists, and we're going to say scientists too, huh? King of the Dinosaur Hunters. A Life of John Bell Hatcher and the Discoveries That Shaped Paleontology by Lowell Dingus. What a great book. Now, he went to these museums. Hatcher was a collector. He actually went to Yale, but he never got a PhD, but they bestowed him one, an honorary degree, of course. But he had, in a real nutshell, over 8,000 nice specimens there. Property of the Carnegie, the Yale Peabody, the American Museum of Natural History. Let's see, the other ones were in Philadelphia and USGS and all of these other places. But he did work, was on as a curator and collector for these. So he is still regarded as the top collector in all of the history up to present in the United States in the American paleontology scene. It's a book from Pegasus Books, New York. And there's Lowell's picture. Oh, Carnegie Museum. Maybe that's who it is, the credits. Lowell Dingus, PhD, is a research associate at the American Museum of Natural History in New York, as well as the Natural History Museum of Los Angeles County. He has directed numerous significant fossil exhibits and has led various paleontological expeditions around the world, including the Patagonian excavation that uncovered the first fossilized skin from an embryonic dinosaur. That's this guy do. So actually, you know, he's following in Hatcher's footsteps because Hatcher went there. He has co-authored several books, including Barnum Brown, who was the number two guy in the world for collecting back then. The Man Who Discovered Tyrannosaurus Rex. Well, that's all the reason right there. This is all about fossils, folks. And Walking on Eggs and the Mistaken Extinction. Lowell lives in New York City. They got a lot of wonderful old pictures here. Now, it was a crazy time. It was a crazy time. This is 1884. There's a lot of wonderful old photos and stuff, but there's some of the very first Triceratops, and they, what an incredible story. And they didn't pay him anything, you know, $100 a month, and $50 a month is all he made. Then he had to beg all the time on these journeys. Send the money, I've got people that he had to work for, and you know, they weigh thousands of pounds, so they had to get rail journeys, and I don't know, he put hauled out like 60,000-70,000 pounds or several thousand tons. I don't know, a lot. A railroad car holds 60 tons, and they put out 120 rail cars of fossils that they dug up. So that's a pretty incredible story. Every year, millions marvel at the skeletons of dinosaurs and other prehistoric creatures discovered by John Bell Hatcher. The life of the King of Collectors is every bit as fascinating as the mighty bones and fossils he unearthed. Hatcher helped discover and mount the most of Carnegie's museum, world-famous 150-year-old million skeleton of Diplodocus, a slender-necked, long-tailed plant-eater whose skeleton has captivated our collective imaginations for more than a century. That isn't all Hatcher discovered. During a legendary collecting campaign in Wyoming between 1889 and 1892, Hatcher discovered a 66 million year old horned dinosaur, Torosaurus, as well as the first scientifically significant set of skeletons from its revolutionary cousin Triceratops. That was the picture I showed her of the three horns. Refusing to restrict his talents to enormous dinosaurs, he also discovered the first significant sample of mammal teeth from our relatives that lived 66 million years ago. The teeth may have been petite, but this extraordinary discovery filled a key gap in humanity's own evolutionary humanity. Hatcher's discoveries form the basis of some of the most beloved and well-known collections and institutions in the world. Yale University's Peabody Museum, the Princeton Collection, the Smithsonian's National Museum of Natural History, and the Carnegie Museum. Nearly 125 years after Hatcher's monumental hunts ended, acclaimed paleontologist Lowell Dingus invites us to revisit Hatcher's captivating expeditions and marvel at this real-life Indiana Jones and the vital role he played in paleontology. That's the true story. Thank you, folks. Now, if you really want to know what we did today, we did a book called Murder by Decree, but that's going to be over at the adult side of the channel. If it ever, and it does get banned, you'll be able to get Murder by Decree over at archive.org. That's where we put all of these books as a backup. Thank you for watching KRAZTV, and I'm the lone journalist, Doc Martin.